and that's all over the world. It doesn't matter where we have it. It's a big seller. Russia, America.
The crab ring. It's your best-selling one.
Yeah, that one there.
That's amazing. So give us a tour of this store. Point out all the different interior stuff, because you've been getting loads of... People have been asking you about all the little props and things,
yeah,
haven't they?
Yeah, I mean, something like that, that Griffin, is, that was completely... We had an intern.
No way.
Well, I found it in a salvage place, and I just thought, well, we can't just have it, you know, sitting there and made of concrete, because that's rubbish. But if we bejewel it... So we started, the idea was we were just going to do the inside of the wings, because it takes hours and hours and hours. And then when we started to see the effects, well, how brilliant that would be if we started to make it like a necklace and pick everything. Every single one of these is a gemstone. So you don't just put some glue on and like rub it in. You've got to put every one, and look that tiny, and right up into the teeth and everything.
That's amazing.
So it came out so well. So we kind of started to pick on other things, like in there, these horseshoe crabs. Now, these things here, well, this is like a living dinosaur. Well, he's not living anymore, they're dead. But I've eaten one.
No way.
Yeah, no, I did in Thailand. I ate
one.
They're
huge, though. What?
Well, this one's got this part missing, but underneath here, it looks like a cockroach. And it's actually, its closest relative is a spider. So it's... even though this still lives, and in Florida, you can still catch these in the sea.
That's absolutely terrifying.
But look at it.
It's amazing. It'll make an amazing hat.
Oh, I made one. We did one. It was like a Lady Gaga kind of a thing, you know? It's like a real surreal
That's
number.
A beautiful thing, yeah. With a little thing poking out the back. Amazing.
But, yeah, that's so funny you said that. So things like that. You see, in my house, for 20 years, I've collected taxidermy, and now I have... things stuffed for me, like the seagull up there is one that was on the beach by the house on the beach. It's dead.
Yeah.
And then I had it
stuffed.
Oh, and now
that's quite green, quite eco.
They buy the seagull. The clock, the shark's jaw clock, we're always making them. I've just finished one for a guy for his yacht. I don't know if you heard earlier, it was
amazing.
Charming. We make the clock. That's a real shark's jaw. And so we buy them like on eBay. And they come just bone.
You buy them on eBay and then the intern puts jewels on them.
Well, we get them doing it now, but all it is it's just so labour intensive. So you've got to kind of...
That's amazing.
People kind of like it though. If someone comes to be an intern and I'm going to go, okay, you're going to be doing that. They go, oh, that's cool. Until they've been doing it for a week, they go, I can't do something else. But so those kind of things. This here was caught off of Kent.
No way.
This is a thornback ray. If you go over to Scott's, it's a thornback ray. If you go to Scott's over the road and order a skate, right, that's what you buy in, a thornback ray. And so I had this stuffed, which is a feat that you cannot believe, because a thornback ray, you see these spines, they're its skeleton. So its skeleton comes through the skin. So whereas with most taxidermy, they kind of split the skin and peel it off and take the body out and then stuff it again. You can't do that with this because its skin and its skeleton are the same thing. So the man who stuffed it, he said, I don't think anyone ever has ever stuffed one before. He said, it's nearly impossible because he had to pick all of the meat out, the bit you would eat normally. And then he substituted it with like a resin inside. But anyway, that's English.
He must dread your phone calls.
He
what you're going to ask him to do next.
You've got to be joking. He's the busiest he's ever been. So these are the astro balls, which are all the star signs.
Okay.
And
do you believe in astrology?
Well, I do now because, you know, I started tea leaf reading. I don't know if you
know that. Are you serious?
Absolutely serious. Well,
what do your tea leaves
if
say?
If you can see the little fella there, that's me, and I'm called the Mystic Tea Leaf. And I've done several events now. I've done in Las Vegas, in Basel, and in Belfast. And I have like my own little room, and I read people's tea. It's a vodka-based tea.
Yeah, I bet.
Grey Goose did. It's called Earl Grey. It's Earl Grey. It's really, the funniest thing is you do it as a joke first.
Right.
And what happens? Well, I'll tell you what happens. It's really hilarious. People start to take it seriously, and the first person who starts to take it seriously, I'm like, come on, this is me. I've got the whole kit. So I've got a big turban, and we sit down. I've got candles everywhere. We do the tea, and then I'll say, oh, you know, I can see, da 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 da. And one woman said to me, are you telling me I should leave my husband? And I was saying, no, I'm not telling you, it's me, I'm like a jeweller. Anyway, then people take it seriously. And the best thing was when I went to Ireland, people in Ireland, you can't muck around with these things because they take these things really seriously. And it was just about 6 weeks ago, and I had two pregnant women in. And I'm thinking, oh my God, this is so much responsibility. Irish pregnant women, they're going to believe everything I say. And I absolutely swear blind, this is not a joke. One of the women that I'd done her reading, she just sent me a letter 2 days ago, an email, and said, I'd just like you to know that I had my boy.
It's so funny. Spooky. Is that what you predicted?
It was because we were joking about these things, but you've got to be really careful because here it is, here, look. That's me up there.
Oh, that's hilarious.
And I wrote all of these. So all of these are... my birthday today.
Yeah, right.
So shall I read you Leo's?
Yes.
Oh, Christ,
in your best mystic Meg voice.
I haven't got my glasses on. Like, gazing into my astro ball, I see a familiar image. Leo the lion, king of the forest and most dominating of the sun signs. Due to their outgoing and imposing demeanour, Leos can often be labelled big-headed. But deep down, this is often just big hair. Inside a Leo is a kitten. Glamorous Stephen Webster wearing felines, Madonna, Barbara Windsor and Jennifer Lopez.
Excellent.
That's for today, August 13th.
That's amazing.